Welcome to Gamer Ability. I'm your host, Sixpinion, and I'm back with another Mario Golf Super Rush gameplay tutorial video. Today, specifically, I'm going to be covering approach shots and chip shots and helping you to learn how you can improve and get closer every single time. If you've missed any of my other tutorials, I highly recommend you check them out, especially my beginner's guide tutorial that goes over really every aspect of the game, a full overview that'll really help you if you're kind of struggling at some of the mechanics in the game. I will have other tutorials coming on all the aspects as the game as well, so be sure to stay tuned to the channel. If you get some enjoyment out of this video, drop a like before you go and subscribe to the channel if you have not done so already. I would greatly appreciate it. I post content every single day, and really my specialty is sports games, but really all games I post content for. So when you're looking at approach shots, the first thing you're going to want to do is look at the range finder so you can actually see the break of the green when you're planning your shot. So the first thing I always do, I hit right trigger, I pull up the range finder, and I hit right trigger to scan. So this is going to give me idea about the green. So you have lines that are horizontal, so moving right to left, and lines that are up and down. You have some in kind of below the hole at the bottom of the screen moving down towards us from up to down. And then you have ones past the hole moving the opposite direction. So they're moving from down to up. So that's indicating, first off, the horizontal lines are showing you which way the ball's gonna move when it hits. It's gonna move in the direction of the line. So if they're moving to the left, the ball's gonna move left when it goes across those grid lines. If they were moving the other way, from left to right, they would row the opposite direction. Now, uphill is indicating that the ball, you're gonna have to hit the ball harder. So you're basically hitting into an upslope or a ramp. So you're gonna actually hit the ball harder than you normally would to get to the hole. So those are the things you're gonna wanna look at in the range finder at the green. Whether you're, when you're putting, it's gonna show the grids anyways, but on chip shots, it actually doesn't show it. You actually have to use the range finder to see that. So for this, so that's what you're gonna do first. The elements you wanna look at for approach shots are at the top of the screen. You see the flag, you see the little arrow that's pointed up, that's elevation. Higher elevated shots, so shots that when the hole's above the ball, you're gonna have to hit it a little harder than you normally would to get there. The more significant, so if you're in a bunker pretty low, you're gonna even have to hit it even harder. I'm gonna go over examples of those in this video as well. We'll be hitting different approach shots. I'm gonna show you kind of my process that I do. Now, you also have the wind on the top left of the screen there, 13 miles per hour, but I will tell you the wind does not affect approach shots very much. It affects them a little bit. One of the most important things that is kind of hard to get your head around, especially if you've played other golf games, is that the rough does not affect the distance that the ball travels in this game. So when you're in the rough, what it changes, you see that red area, the shift area? That's what it changes. That area gets bigger. When you hit on the power bar in those regions, that's when the randomness comes in. It's either going to go to the left, go to the right. It may come up a little bit short than it normally comes up. So that's what the rough does. But the rough in general, you don't have to change your distance. If you don't know that, you're always going to hit it past the hole. Same thing for bunkers. Bunkers don't really affect the distance, but the reason bunkers affect the distance is because you're always low. So they're always in a little dip, so you always have to hit the ball harder. So the bunkers themselves maybe take off about a yard or two, but most of that is because of the elevation changes when you're in them. But now in bunkers, that shift area is going to be big, and you'll see some bunkers examples in this video. So in general, when I look at approach shots, I always hit a backspin approach shot. So when you take a look at that power bar to the right of the screen, you're going to see those green squares. So you have the light green squares and dark green squares. I use those squares to dictate where I'm going to land, how much power I need to hit. In general, on approach shots, when I'm doing the backspin approach, I'm going to show you what that is. I'm going to aim about 4 of those small grids less than the hole and roll it up to make it or get close. The other method you could, I don't recommend doing the normal shot. So AA, if you do AA, you're always going to get too much roll. And if you're hitting from the rough or bunker, you're going to get more roll anyways. So you're always going to get more roll from the rough and bunker. So if you don't put backspin on it, that ball is going to go too far. So I always recommend either using backspin, so you'll hit A and use B to set the power. That's normal backspin. Or you can do super backspin. Super backspin, you'll hit, that's when you want to plant it like right next to the hole. So you want to hit it and get it to stop. If you're playing with characters with higher spin rates, you can really get that to stop. Now, when I do that, instead of my normal four squares in front of the ball, 3 to 4 squares, I would probably land about 2 squares, 2 to 3 with super backspin. So to do super backspin, if you didn't watch the beginner's guide video, you'll click A and tap B and then B again very quickly. So you'll hit B twice to set your power. That's going to add super backspin. So you hit A, you set your power with B and push B again really quickly. That's going to add super backspin. So let's take a look at this shot. We know in general, we can see the power bar. We can see that it always shows you where the flag is there. In general, I'm going to land 4 grid lines before, but we haven't looked at any of the other elements. The other elements are the elevation, the wind. With the wind barely affects it. Like there's no headwind here. So sometimes a headwind would affect the ball, maybe a yard. So headwinds, basically a yard, tailwinds don't really affect the approach shot at all, unless it's like very like 20 miles per hour. So for this example, I need to take into account that it is elevated. So if I do normally 4 squares, typically is my 4 squares less, I'm going to hit about 3 squares less. Because it's elevated, I need to hit the ball a little bit harder. The other element that you need to look at is that the green, it's a little bit uphill. So it, as you can see, it's barely uphill, so I don't need to add anything. But if these grid lines were moving faster, they were red in color, because if they're red in color, that means they're breaking more. White in color basically means flat. Blue in color is moderate break. Red in color is more significant break. So this case, it's not really affecting it. So I'm going to stay at 3 squares on the power gauge. Now, keep in mind, that's 3 of those small, dark. So 3 squares is 3, the small squares. So the right on the power bar there, you have the green squares. I would aim 3 less of where the flag is on that thing, on the power bar. Now, the other thing you have to take a look at is the lie angle. So are Mario's feet below the ball? And this game does this easy for you. It basically does it for you because you look at the power bar. So you can see that the power bar is going straight, but then it veers off to the left. That's showing that that's because of the lie, that in general, I need to aim to the right just a little bit. You're never going to have to aim too far because of it. Just a touch to the right to compensate. The other thing, you want to plan ahead. So this green is sloping from right to left. So that means when my ball hits, it's going to roll to the left. Now I'm using backspin. So into an uphill lie, we're not going to get a lot of spin, but I'm going to move it a little bit to the right. So we have our spot. We've selected our spot. Now keep in mind, you're going to do this really quick. I'm doing it slow for the tutorial just so you all can get a glimpse. But in general, it's a backspin. 3 to 4, usually it's 4 of those small squares before the hole is the amount of spin you're going to put on it. So if you're using an approach wedge or pitching wedge, you're going to get more rollout with backspin. So in those cases, you would have to aim a little bit shorter. So 4 to 5 squares, 6 squares. If it's downhill, and we're going to do other examples in this video that I'm going to show you, but if it's downhill, you would have to aim a square or two shorter if you're using backspin, because your ball is going to roll down the hill. And a lot of times when I'm hitting into a slope that's rolling downhill towards the hole, I will actually go ahead and do super backspin in that example so it doesn't roll too far. But let's go ahead and hit the shot. So I'm going to hit A, set my power with B about 3 grid lines short. All right, so my game froze, but what I did, I reset and I hit it to a similar spot. So the shot will be a little bit different than what it was, but let's take a look at it. So instead of it being, so we're a little bit further back here. It's still uphill. It's red uphill. So we can see those lines moving from up to down. when we right in front of the hoe, it's breaking to the right. So lie angle is similar. It's breaking to the left, but nothing of that changed. I'm still going to do about 3 grid lines short. Now, one important aspect that I mentioned that the wind does not really affect the distance of the shot. But I will tell you the direction when you have high winds. So when you're in that strong wind category, 13 miles per hour above, if it's a side wind like this, I mean, a crosswind, it's going to affect it. So you need to aim to the left to compensate in this situation because the wind, the arrow is pointed to the right, which means it's blowing from left to right. So in this, I'm not even going to worry about it. I'm going to do the lie angle first so we can see that it's slightly, the lines at my feet are moving to the left. The power bar is slanting to the left, so the ball is going to come off to the left. So I'm going to move a little bit to the right. But now for the wind, I usually do about half, so 13 miles per hour. I'm going to move about 7 like quick flicks of the stick to the left, or just you just eyeball it a full grid line to the left because it's going to kick it. And then from there, we're going to hit land the 3 grid lines short and hit the shot. Now, a thing that changed about this shot is it's not uphill anymore. So I need to actually go back to my normal hitting spot, the 4 to 5 squares instead of that I was at the 3 squares because of the elevation. So let's go ahead and do that and then hit the shot. So I landed a little bit farther than I wanted. Yeah, so I was trying. So I went about 2.5 squares, 2.5, 3 squares. I was trying to land 4 to 5 squares short. But still, it was a pretty good shot. It could have been better if I would have set my power right, but that's going to happen. Sometimes it's hard to set the power on these shorter shots. If I would have, that's another example. If I would have done super backspin, we would have been right next to the hole with that 2.5, 3 grid line spot. So that's, if you're using the super backspin method, the grid lines, instead of being that 4 to 5 marker, my general rule is 4. With normal backspin, with normal flat surfaces. With uphill, I'm gonna land it a little further than that, so that'd be 3 grid lines, or 3 of those small squares on the power bar. If it's downhill, I'm gonna land 5 to 6 squares before, or shoot 5 to 6 squares before the flag. So that's kind of my general rules there. But a lot of times on downhill shots, I will do super backspin. But let's go ahead and move on to the next example. So let's take a look at this next approach shot. This is really a straightforward chip, but the element that's added onto this is that it's raining now. So it's raining, which means we need to hit the ball a little bit harder because the ball is not going to roll as much. So it's basically going to, with the backspin method, it's going to hit and stick. And that's, I like that. So as we take a look at the shot, always, I like to use the rangefinder always to get a look at the break of the green to see where we need to aim. So if we land on that grid line right behind the hole, it's sloping to the left. So I need to aim slightly to the right in order to make the shot because my ball is going to hit and roll to the left. You see all the grid lines moving towards us. That means this shot is slightly uphill towards the hole. So we need to... really, in this case, hit it a little bit harder than we normally would. Instead of my normal 3 to 4 grid lines, for 3 to 4 power grid lines, those small squares on the power grid, for my normal backspin shots. In this case, we have the rain. We need to hit this a touch harder. So instead of that 3 to 4 squares, we're going to hit actually 1 to 2 squares. So I'm going to actually try to hit about 1.5 squares in front of the hole and do the same backspin. Aim a little bit to the right. The lie angle is not affecting it. It's basically flat. The power bar is not moving left or right. So we're going to go right for this to see if we can make the shot. So I hit it way too hard. Yep, so way too hard than I wanted, but nice. I put backspin on it. That's the importance of backspin, gamers. With that backspin, I made sure I did not roll too far. So I overhit my power, but you could see there, if I actually hit 1.5 grid line short, we would have been right next to the hole. It might have even went into the hole. So let's go ahead and move on to the next approach shot. So let's take a look at a bunker example, and this is a more difficult bunker shot because of how uphill the shot is and the distance of the shot. So let's get our rangefinder. Let's take a look at it. Now, bunkers in general, as I've said, rough and bunkers do not really affect the distance very much. We gotta find the, sometimes it's hard to find the pin when you're in these spots. So there we go, we found it. Okay, and you always look at the break. It's flat by the green, but it is, we can see lines moving up towards the top of the screen there, which means it is slightly downhill. So we need to hit it a little shorter than we normally would. So my normal 3 to 4 grid lines when using backspin would be a little bit less. So I'd hit about 4 or 5 instead of that 3. Now, we are in the sand though, and it is uphill. So we need to compensate for that. So we, since this is such a uphill lie, it's a highly elevated shot, we need to add, in this case, this is pretty significant, I would add about 4 or 5 squares to my normal shot. So that means I would actually be aiming right at the flag on the power marker, maybe even a little more than that. In this example, I'm probably gonna hit like 1.5 bars past the flag on the power bar. But in that area, we can see, so the big thing that bunkers and rough affect are that shift zone. That red area, if we hit where we need to, it can be pretty significant. Now you can counteract that by going up a club to the approach wedge, hit X, you're gonna have a little less shift, and you can go up to a pitching wedge and do the same thing. The problem with that is both, as you move up, your ball is gonna get more roll, and it's harder to get backspin on it. Sand wedge are always the easiest when hitting out of the bunker. That's why the game always defaults you to them. But now as we hit the shot, we need to take, so we already have our distance mapped out, but we also need to take a look at the lie angles. We can see that the power bar is slanted to the right, and that the feet, as we can see, I know Rosalina floats, it's kind of hard to see that lie, but as we move and let up, we can see that all those lines are slanted to the right, which means the ball is going to go to the right. Whichever way those lines are moving is the way the ball is going to go off once it leaves the club. So we need to aim a little bit to the left to compensate, not too much. And I'm going to do my normal backspin. We're going to aim about 1.5 to 2 grid lines past the flag, and let's hit the shot. Pretty good distance. We got the distance we wanted. We got the backspin, and that was perfect. Nice. So we got exactly where we wanted, and it worked out perfect. So as you can see, the bunker did not affect distance very much, did it? The elevation did, but the bunker itself did not take off a lot of distance. And that's very important to remember when hitting from the bunkers, when hitting from the rough in this game, in general, whether it's approach shot or a full wedge shot, it's not gonna affect distance. So keep that in mind. Now the elevation changes and wind will affect distance, but not the rough and bunker themselves. We accounted for the bunker a little bit, like 1 or 2 squares, and we accounted for the elevation significantly because it was uphill. So it did affect the distance, but not to a large extent. That backspin we put on was perfect. If I did not put backspin out of the sand there, that ball would have been probably 5 yards past the hole. So now you know how to hit bunker shots. You can use those, that same techniques front when you're hitting out of the fairway bunkers or anything like that. But I'll have other videos coming out for putting, for other aspects of the game as well. But I highly recommend use the backspin on the shots. I hope you found this video helpful. I'll be doing other videos on putting, hitting other shots, and some shot shaping methods that you can do. So be on the lookout for those. If you missed my first tutorial, the beginner's guide, it really goes over everything in the game that you need to know to improve. Be sure you check out that video. Click on the links in the description. Thank you for all the support, everybody. If you got some enjoyment out of this video, drop a like before you go. I'd greatly appreciate it. And subscribe to the channel if you have not done so already. I will see you in the next video. Be sure to check out the Ryan Gamer. He's the multi-sport athlete on the channel. You'll see him in every type of sports game on there, and my other gaming videos on the Gamerability YouTube channel. As always, have a fantastic day, gamers.